Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in the Cube, and in this video, I want to go over the pane switcher that comes with on object editing and talk about some of the nuances of it that kind of threw me off a little bit. I want to make sure that you understand what's going on. So, enough of all this talking. You know, we like to do it here on Guy in the Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. So if you're not familiar with on object editing and you don't have it enabled, this is what you will see. Here you're gonna see the visualization pane as well as the data pane. I'll call it the old experience. And so to enable on object editing, first we're gonna go to file, we're gonna go to options, and then we're gonna come down to preview features and enable on object interaction. And this is gonna cause a restart of Power BI Desktop. I know that change is hard and some people have not liked the on object editing for various reasons. It's a different experience from what you have, but they also came out with some updates that I think make it easier to adopt for those that aren't liking the existing experience. So let's go over and I'll walk through that. All right, so now we've got on object editing enabled. And what you're gonna see here now is you see this data pane and we also see this bar over here. First thing I want to call your attention to is that little gear icon in the actual lower right. And so if I click on that, that's a shortcut right away to get to the settings option where you saw me in the beginning go through the file and the options and the options. This just brings you right to it. So I love that. Now we've got this data pane and we can do a couple things. You'll see here this data tab as part of it. And then you'll see this plus icon. So we can customize the pane. And I want to say, let's enable all of these. Why not? They're here. Let's make sure that they're not lonely. And when we do that, we'll see that we have other options here on the side. The actual on object editing happens here. When you select a visual, you'll see that we can add data and build. And this is happening right on the visual itself. That was one thing that was a little hard for me before is when it was in the visualization on the far right. Sometimes I got a little lost if I had a few visuals of like, all right, wait, which one was selected? Or do I need to select the other one? So the fact that this is attached to the visual itself, I like it. So we can change the fields and this changes up depending on which visual that we're attached to. You can choose the visual type. All of these items are available. So now what'll happen here, first thing I want to point you out to is when we select one, we'll see that we switch through the different items. That's great. But what if I want data and format together? This is the first quirk I'm going to point out to you. So first off, what you can do is you can right click and say, open in a new pane. That's great. The thing that you got to be careful of, let me go ahead and collapse this, is that if this is already out, so if I right click on that, I can't open in a new pane because it's already there. So if I wanted format next to data, I'll choose data first and then right click on format and say open a new pane, or you could go the other direction. Either way works. And this can get crazy too. Watch this. Let's go ahead, new pane, new pane, new pane. New pane. This is my new work experience. This is my layout. You saw it first. No, I kid. Another quirk I'm going to point out to you is by default, when I originally was messing with this, was I went and said, okay, well, I want to hit the X and, you know, it'll still be over here, but watch this. So selections, which is down here on the bottom. Wait. Why? They all disappeared. I personally would have preferred that this just collapses instead of close. I want it to stay on the bar. So there's a few extra clicks if you want that behavior. If I want to keep the format here, click on the little drop down and say collapse instead and it stays. And I can bring them back. It's not like they're gone forever. It's not like I did like a Thanos snap on it and they're gone forever. No, they're still there. We can enable it. The other thing your eyes are going to be drawn to is this build a visual and it's grayed out. What do we do? I mentioned before that on object editing, when I'm in the visual, I can go in and I can select the actual visual items here. And this is great. One thing you'll notice here is this little drop down caret thing. If I click on that, I can add to the pane switcher. Bam. Now it's on the pane switcher. And if I select different visuals, look at that. Are you kidding me? So now you can have the pane so it's not attached to the visual directly and you kind of get that old style. So if that's your jam, then you can do that now. This is actually a new option that was added recently and definitely take advantage of it. Or if you kind of were like, I don't want to use on object editing, check it out again and see if this is a better behavior for you if you liked the old experience. All right, so this is great. But now if I want it back in the old experience, I can come up here and I can say move to the visual. Great. And now we'll see that we're back at the visual. One word of caution, as I was playing around with this, sometimes it got lost, I guess, where when I moved it back to the visual, it wasn't showing up on the visual anymore. And then I couldn't get it back in the on the pane itself. I'm sure that will get resolved. The last couple times I've done this, I haven't had a problem, but just know that you may run into that. The way I got around it, close Power BI Desktop, come back in, and you're back. Okay, so a couple different ways to do this. So I mentioned add to the pane switcher. The other thing you can do is if we go over to view, and we go to pane switcher, you can also say move build a visual to the pane switcher. There's also an option, if we go back to settings, you'll see this option here, always show the build a visual menu in the pane switcher. And so if we select that and then restart Power BI Desktop, then it's just always gonna be here. And when we restart Power BI Desktop, that's where it'll be. And you'll notice this is checked now. If I get rid of that, then we're back to the way it was. And you'll see I'm back into that state that I mentioned about before where I don't have my visual. And so if I restart Power BI Desktop, then that's good. I can also come back here and we're good to go. Hopefully you're playing around with on object editing and the panes. I personally like it. Let me know in the comments what your thoughts are. I would love to hear it. And as always, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.